What first world problems are actually serious issues that need serious attention? I would have to say it would be work-life balance. Basically, myself and a lot of people I know simply don't take vacations anymore because we have too much work to do all the time. We just accrue vacation days and never really use them. Sometimes it's the company culture, sometimes it's the work, sometimes it's I'm getting paid too much to go on vacation. But overall, it's a real problem, as burnout is very, very real, and why we've been seeing an uptick in people having a meltdown and completely leaving their profession. Work culture in the United States has gotten toxic. You're expected to be all in all the time and to put work above basically everything else, which is in turn causing more people to have anxiety and panic attacks. I know I personally have extreme anxiety and know it is work related. And I'm one of the lucky ones that likes the people I work with and have gotten positive reviews, so it's not a fear of being called out for not being good at what I do. But the fear of losing a job is still there. Hanging around Reddit, I've started to feel more and more privileged to be a Swede. Not only is it a legal right to have at least 2 weeks continuous vacation every summer, you get full pay when taking vacation days, and with a small extra bonus. A lot of people are living in homes with dangerously outdated electrical wiring. It is expensive to rewire a house, so generally it's only done after something goes very wrong. My grandparents lived in their house from 1960 to 2003. Most rooms did not have grounded outlets, and the 6 fuse panel in the basement, hidden behind a picture frame, looked like a house fire waiting to happen. The basement had all sorts of exposed wires, alligator clips and rubber bands holding things together. At one point, ringing the doorbell would turn off the TV, or something absurd like that. A rise in chronic autoimmune diseases. There are a few theories, my fave being the hygiene hypothesis. We're much cleaner now. The immune system doesn't know how to handle it, freaks out. I have lupus, so I've definitely got some skin in the game. Google's lupus symptoms, is confident that skin in the game isn't a pun. Life expectancy and quality of life. We're really good at keeping people alive longer, but god awful at that extra time being relevant or meaningful. Along the same lines, people not retiring and the subsequent jobs not opening up for new generation to replace them. Being poor, but not destitute. I have a full-time job. I have a car. I make 25k a year. I don't qualify for food stamps or government assistance. I can barely make my ends meet. I am paycheck to paycheck, and I don't see an easy way out. I can't afford school because I make too much to get full tuition coverage, but I can't afford it. I have health insurance, but even with it, a serious surgery or accident will financially cripple me. I can't go to the doctor. I think I have fairly severe sleep apnea, but I won't know because I can't afford the first doctor's visit, let alone the treatment or testing. And there's no help for me. I make too much. I am too well off. I am stuck. And so many others like me are too. The worst is not being able to go to the doctor. There are so many things that I would go to the doctor for if I could. Sleep apnea being one of them. But even the appointment to discuss treatment and diagnosis is too expensive. Canadian here, at 20, I spent a year in Australia and was impressed by the amount of people who went to trade or vocational school. There was hardly any talk of how everyone needs college to get a decent job. In fact, the blue collar and everyman is totally celebrated in Australia. No degree, no problem. Get yourself some training and be paid fairly for the work you do after you're finished. The whole go to college, get a degree and be successful trope is so balls. I noticed this when traveling too. It's weird in Scotland, where I'm from. You almost expect an educated sounding person to have gone to university. In reality, I met many Aussies who were smart as frick who worked as plumbers or whatever. In the UK, it's often seen as something you do if you're too dumb to hack university. Longer hours at office jobs. Sure, it's warm, safe, even cushy to an extent. Some who work long hours might even earn good salaries, have decent benefits, and are able to provide for a family. But it's a symptom of a larger issue, stress, and mental illness. People often feel chained to their desks. The office becomes a mental prison, filled with anxiety, stress, doubt, and frustration. It builds up over time, and most office workers don't take breaks, mentally or physically, until they're too exhausted to think about it any longer. All that matters is managing the workload, eating, drinking water, stretching, going outside. They become secondary for too many people. It's the perfect environment for a silent, ill-defined mental illness that will continue to grow until office culture shifts to be more flexible and accommodating. And even if your company culture claims to be flexible and accommodating, those who take advantage of it are still looked down upon. That more people die from obesity-related causes than from war, crime, starvation and disease combined. It sounds crazy, but it is actually a legit problem that is getting worse. TLDR, too much prosperity can kill you. Infrastructure in the US and other first world countries is aging badly. Cities have crumbling sewers and roads, and our national electric grid is a kludge of haphazard networks and providers that are stitched together in a manner that almost guarantees power disruptions and blackouts, not even touching on the power grid's susceptibility to EMP and cyber attack. Pay for the highest tier health insurance. Get hurt, go to the in-networker, out-of-network doctor on duty, now I'm on the hook for full cost. Boredom in small towns, particularly among young people. I grew up in a small town on Ireland's west coast and there was never anything to do but walk aimlessly to the same old spots, sit there for a while, and then move on to the next. Add alcohol to the equation and it becomes an even worse problem. This is a big problem around me as well. Small town. 45 minutes till you get to a town that has slightly more to do. Think fast food and 2-3 small stores. Many people get involved with drugs or early in Planned Parenthood. My old high school has a 15% pregnancy rate for the girls that go there. The work culture, at least in the US Midwest, is pretty freaking stupid IMO and should be looked at. There's this weird mentality that 40 hours a week is just the bare minimum of what you should do and you're better if you work more. And heaven forbid you get enough sleep at night because you could be using that time to get work done. Sleep when you're dead. Now get back to work. People not completing their entire antibiotic course. This is what has lead significantly contributed to the rise of drug-resistant versions of sicknesses. For the last 16 years or so, the government has just kind of slowly been chipping away at what used to be considered sacred rights. They're presently getting ready to extend their own authority to just conduct long-term surveillance on you for no reason. Wiretap your phone, get your internet activity, etc. And the scary part is that the majority of people don't really seem to care anymore. People putting a perfectly curated version of their entire lives up on social media in order to get validation, and, often, to make money off it, leading everyone else to feel that their own life is lesser by comparison. People are comparing the rough cut of their lives to everyone else's highlight reel. It's no wonder that dissatisfaction is through the roof. I really like the second part, really nicely worded. The cost of childcare is out of control. With a huge lack of affordable programs to assist working parents, it becomes a terrible cycle when you have to get childcare to maintain a job yet spend a large portion of your income on childcare so that you can even go to work in the first place. I've known several white-collar couples who were pretty high up in their field, where one parent had to quit and be a stay-at-home parent after their second or third kid because the cost of childcare was higher than one of their salaries. Upper and upper middle class people treating their children as success objects, narcissistic extensions of themselves. It's possible for a child to grow up with all the physical comforts possible, and to be emotionally starving in the most horrible way. Student loan debt. Institutions for higher education should be treated as investments into the nation's future, rather than mere profit centers. Overproduction of trash. We literally send old computers, ships, etc. to the developing world to be disposed of because the cost and environmental regulations make it impractical in first world countries. The lack of any sense of nuance and discourse. It used to be only on the internet but now real life arguments are the same way. All or nothing, black and white, is not how reality works. Actually having vacation time but not using it because you'll be considered lazy. Frick the US work environment, it's crap. The internet should be considered a utility like gas, water and electricity. Considering that you need the internet to do business with the government, I can't understand why it isn't. A person can live without a phone, but I can't imagine anyone who isn't a Ted Kaczynski type person being able to function without the internet. I just read something about a bunch of cities in Colorado that were voting to make it a utility. Obesity. With food being abundantly easy to get hold of, and a lack of necessity to go out and move, the human race is slowly eating itself to death. The cost of obesity on a country in healthcare is obscene. The amount of inefficiency is obscene. The fact that some people are eating so much that they die young, whilst others in the world are starving to death is obscene. Depression and anxiety. I've seen a lot of people go boohoo, you don't have anything to be sad about, and all you have to worry about is your bills. It's a disorder, doesn't matter the circumstances, it can affect anyone, and it's not fun. Wholeheartedly agree. The entire premise of the disorder is that we don't always get upset in a rational manner, or even for a reason at all. Upset being a floating term, I guess. There are better words for it. Men who are taught all their worth is in the job they have, the money they make, how beautiful their wife is, and how big the house is that they can buy, and how many of them. Women who are taught that all they are worth is how beautiful they are, how rich and successful is the man they can win to marry, how beautiful their house is decorated, and how superficially successful their children are. It's a culture that tries to turn humans into robots. It's an awful competition, because the biggest winners are actually the ones who lose out on having any sort of emotionally real and fulfilling life. These people age into bitter and mean late middle age. These are the bosses who embarrass their employees in front of their colleagues for no reason, who promise one job but they make the person do something else, who grope and harass the women around him, who have empty affairs where everyone ends up worse off in an effort to make himself still feel powerful. These are the women who act like you have committed a war crime if you accidentally brush up against them on the street, who treat cashiers and sales clerks like their personal slaves. Their deep misery and emptiness leaks out into becoming these petty tyrants of their lives. Headache and migraine. With the stresses of modern day life and constant work pressure, much of the US workforce is being affected. During college I became aware of the culture we seem to have as millennials. The idea that we always need to be busy. It is cool to say, oh I'm so busy, or sorry I can't hang out I'm busy. And we really are busy and we're tired for it, but we're running around at 100 miles per hour going nowhere because we're so busy. I just want to relax, and that's okay. Depression. Nobody really takes it seriously. Typically ends with oh, stop feeling sorry for yourself, or it's just a phase. Or my mother's personal favorite, you're just hungry. All these serious answers and I came here to say that it's hard to warm up those garlic butter cups you get when you order pizza if you decide you want to eat some as leftovers. You have to take the top off and it just bubbles and pops if you heat it for more than 6 seconds, so you constantly have to start and stop it over and over, and holy cow it gets old fast. So you come up with a good idea to stir it, but it doesn't stir super well yet, and now you just dirted a spoon and it's just one more thing you have to wash. You get the idea to just wipe the spoon on some pizza so you won't waste any of the delicious butter, but it isn't the right temperature, so it's not really warm or really cold, and it's in that uncomfortable middle stage where all food tastes off for some reason. You still have to worry about the butter, so you do the microwave on and off thing maybe 2 or 3 more times and then it's finally done, and if you don't think that is a first world problem that needs to be fixed, then I don't know what is. Depression and anxiety that come with the pressures of being raised in certain areas, families, and even the pressures people with good jobs face, including the pressure to make it look perfect from the outside. It's a real problem and growing, but people dismiss it as, oh I'd love to have a job that pays that much. You shouldn't complain about the hours verbal abuse you get at work. We all go through it. You're lucky your parents were able to support you through university. Most people don't have that. You have everything you could want. You have no reason to be unhappy. Just make it work. It's just completely dismissed. Pharmaceutical drugs. The freaking opioid epidemic here in the US is crazy. Saw a post earlier with an article talking about how our life expectancy dropped a little bit for the second year in a row, and the main contributor was overdose. On the other side, trying to get sufficient chronic pain management in the US is a unique kind of torture. Being denied pain medication due to other people's addictions is basically cruel and unusual punishment for having health problems. Lack of paid family leave in USA. Even if you ignore the negative impacts it has on women in work, which we shouldn't ignore, the social mobility limiting effects it has on lower middle upper middle class families is enough to get serious about. Loot boxes and video games actually exploit gambling addiction tendencies, in many cases normalizing the gambling process for young people. It primes them to be more susceptible and open to real gambling. It grooms them. Gambling addiction ruins lives. All I wanted was to unlock Darth Vader and I ended up with $250,000 invested in Bitcoin. Bullying in schools, including cyberbullying. Oh, kids are calling you names? Kids are starving in third world countries and you are complaining about people calling you names? Dude, frick you. Other people treating you like a human being is a fundamental right. This is along the same lines as the question, but not exactly the same. When the Atlanta airport lost power and everyone was panicking at first, a lot of people there thought it was a terrorist attack at first and didn't know what to do. A lot of the airport work just straight up stopped working and didn't help people. It was a total mess. So of course people get on social media and complain as they should. Their holiday travel plans just got thrown for a loop and they're obviously upset. So what do people reply with? Oh, Puerto Rico hasn't had power in 2 months. Suck it up. This has always pissed me off when people do this because it deflects someone's totally legit problem just because someone else in the world might have a problem worse than it. It's called whataboutism. US education system is crap. Being in debt for your entire life is insane. Healthcare in the US is crap. If I put saving money over my personal health, there is a freaking problem. Distribution of wealth in the US is insane. Distribution of our taxes is freaking insane. Lobbying is fine, but the fact that money from lobbying can fund politicians' expenses is freaking insane. This country is literally retarded and being fricked by greed. The US is long overdue for a complete overhaul. I love the USA, but the system right now isn't going to work very much longer. How repressed and lonely we are. We try and fill the void with cheap food, drugs and TV instead of living a meaningful life that would traditionally revolve around family. Minimum wages. There should be a cost of living wage instead of minimum. A wage that can support the one person. People already want to live better than alone in a small apartment, basic foods, and basic care. We don't need to make it hard to afford. If the small stuff is already hard to afford, it makes it that much harder to reach the better stuff. Humanity isn't here to be slaves to paper. We all want a good and quality life, not just the rich or well off. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.